control. Duh! Arms! Open more. Duh! March! Stand at ease. Stand easy.
Okay. number two half company. Hold! Number two half company. Right! Turn! Slope! Sword!
Number three half company.
Turn! Sword!
Thank you.
Turn.
Shoulder! Up! Down! 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 complete artillery! Halt! Royal Fleet Artillery about turn!
Taken there. Sun's coming through the gap. Taken there. Stand in the shade now. Good day to be wearing black.
Stand easy.
Come on. Slow. Hi.
like a woodpecker. Funny, isn't it? Old creepy ferrets, huh? I'm not, it's going to stand out now.
Companies by the left, quick march. Thank you.
Thank you. body. Look, swords.
Well, we've just got the king. We've got, just got the king's suit coming up down the left hand side of the golf course now. So golf course.
Run! airport. Blow. Not.
Thank you. We are here today in St. George's Chapel to commit into the hands of God the soul of his servant Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh. With grateful hearts, we remember the many ways in which his long life has been a blessing to us. We have been inspired by his unwavering loyalty to our Queen, by his service to the nation and the Commonwealth, by his courage, fortitude, and faith. Our lives have been enriched through the challenges that he has set us, the encouragement that he has given us, his kindness, humour, and humanity. We therefore pray that God will give us grace to follow his example, and that with our brother Philip, at the last, we shall know the joys of life eternal. From the book Ecclesiasticus. Look at the rainbow and praise its maker. It shines with a supreme beauty, rounding the sky with its gleaming arc, a bow bent by the hands of the Most High. His command speeds the snowstorm and sends the swift lightning to execute his sentence. To that end, the storehouses are opened and the clouds fly out like birds. By his mighty power, the clouds are piled up and the hailstones broken small. The crash of his thunder makes the earth writhe, and when he appears, an earthquake shakes the hills. At his will, the south wind blows, the squall from the north, and the hurricane. He scatters the snowflakes like birds alighting. They settle like a swarm of locusts. The eye is dazzled by their beautiful whiteness, and as they fall, the mind is entranced. He spreads frost on the earth like salt, and icicles form like pointed stakes. A cold blast from the north, and ice grows hard on the water, settling on every pool, as though the water were putting on a breastplate. He consumes the hills, scorches the wilderness, and withers the grass like fire. Cloudy weather quickly puts all to rights, and dew brings welcome relief after heat. By the power of his thought, he tamed the deep and planted it with islands. Those who sail the sea tell stories of its dangers, which astonish all who hear them. In it are strange and wonderful creatures, all kinds of living things and huge sea monsters. By his own action, he achieves his end, and by his word, all things are held together.
To the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. A reading from St. John's Gospel. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. And even now I know that whatever you ask from God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in the resurrection at the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord. I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, he who is coming into the world."
his breath and life is ended. Your breath goes forth and life begins. Your hand renews the face of earth. Your grace. My whole life I will sing.
My soul give praise unto the
merciful God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, in whom whosoever believeth shall live though he die, and whosoever liveth and believeth in him shall not die eternally, who also hath taught us by his holy apostle St. Paul, not to be sorry as men without hope for them that sleep in him. We meekly beseech thee, O Father, that when we shall depart this life, we may rest in him, as our hope is this our brother doth, and that at the general resurrection in the last day, we may be found acceptable in thy sight and receive that blessing which thy well-beloved Son shall then pronounce to all that love and fear thee, saying, Come, ye blessed children of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, we beseech thee, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer. Amen.
O eternal God, before whose face the generations rise and pass away, thyself unchanged, abiding, we bless thy holy name for all who have completed their earthly course in thy faith and following, and are now at rest. We remember before thee this day Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, rendering thanks unto thee for his resolute faith and loyalty, for his high sense of duty and integrity, for his life of service to the nation and Commonwealth, and for the courage and inspiration of his leadership. To him, with all the faithful departed, grant thy peace. Let light perpetual shine upon them, and in thy loving wisdom and almighty power, work in them the good purpose of thy perfect will. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. O Lord, who didst give to thy servant Saint George grace to lay aside the fear of man and to be faithful even unto death, grant that we, unmindful of worldly honour, may fight the wrong, uphold thy rule, and serve thee to our life's end, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. God save our gracious Sovereign, and all the companions living and departed, of the most honourable and noble order of the Garter. Amen. O God of the spirits of all flesh, we praise thy holy name for thy servant Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, who has left us a fair pattern of valiant and true knighthood. Grant unto him the assurance of thine ancient promise that thou wilt ever be with those who go down to the sea in ships and occupy their business in great waters. And we beseech thee that, following his good example and strengthened by his fellowship, we may at the last, together with him, be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
O Lord God, when thou givest to thy servants to endeavour any great matter, grant us also to know that it is not the beginning, but the continuing of the same unto the end, until it be thoroughly finished, which yieldeth the true glory. Through him who for the finishing of thy work laid down his life, our Redeemer Jesus Christ. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies and giver of all comfort, deal graciously, we pray thee, with those who mourn, that casting every care on thee, they may know the consolation of thy love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Go forth upon thy journey from this world, O Christian soul, in the name of God the Father Almighty, who created thee, in the name of Jesus Christ, who suffered for thee, in the name of the Holy Spirit, who strengtheneth thee. May thy portion this day be in peace, and thy dwelling in the heavenly Jerusalem. Amen.
Thus it hath pleased Almighty God to take out of this transitory life, unto his divine mercy, the late most high, mighty, and illustrious prince, Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, Earl of Merioneth, and Baron Greenwich, Knight of the Most Noble Order of the Garter, Knight of the Most Ancient and Most Noble Order of the Thistle, Member of the Order of Merit, Knight Grand Cross of the Royal Victorian Order, upon whom had been conferred the Royal Victorian Chain, Grand Master and Knight Grand Cross of the Most Excellent Order of the British Empire, Lord High Admiral of the United Kingdom, one of Her Majesty's Most Honorable Privy Council, Admiral of the Fleet, Field Marshal in the Army, and Marshal of the Royal Air Force, husband of Her Most Excellent Majesty, Elizabeth II, by the grace of God of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, and of her other realms and territories, Queen, Head of the Commonwealth, Defender of the Faith, Sovereign of the Most Noble Order of the Garter, whom may God preserve and bless with long life, health and honor, and all worldly happiness.
God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, and the Commonwealth, and all people, unity, peace, and concord. And to us and all God's servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you all and remain with you always. Amen.